What's up, guys? Welcome to the Nerf Dudes. Today, as in the name, I will be reviewing the Adventure Force Spectrum. Here's the unboxing. With the Spectrum is the blaster itself, instructions, 10-dart magazine, retractable stock, scope, and 10 green wafflehead darts. Here's a quick overview of the blaster. The Adventure Force Spectrum is a flywheeler that runs off of 6 AA batteries. It comes with 2 rail attachments that will fit on your other Adventure Force / Dart Zone blasters. So if you have, say, a Blitzfire or Villainator, the Spectrum scope will fit snugly on both. The Spectrum foregrip also fits on the Blitzfire or other Dart Zone / Adventure Force blasters that have an underbarrel rail. It's not the most comfortable, but it might be to your taste. End strike rail attachments do also technically work on these rails, it's just not as clicky. End strike stock attachments and barrel attachments do not fit on the Spectrum though. The Spectrum also, of course, comes with this retractable stock. In my opinion, it's a little short, so if you have a Villainator, I definitely suggest swapping stocks from the Spectrum and Villainator, because the Villainator stock is much more comfortable. Batteries are installed as shown. This blaster takes 6 AA batteries. Once you've installed your batteries, you can now rev it. And that will power up the flywheels, which will allow you to push a dart into them, which will propel them. The access door is located on the left side of the blaster. The Spectrum still hasn't given me any problems with jams after having it for about 2 months, but it makes a cool faux bolt for when you're reloading. And all blasters should have jam doors, just in case. There is no paint anywhere on this blaster. But Adventure Force still managed to make it look pretty cool by adding some gray plates in some places and some integrated orange in some places, like on the jam door, the top rail, and some of the barrel. As far as grips go, the Spectrum grip is pretty average. Not too small, not too big, but just a little slim. As you see down here, the rev trigger is a little big, and honestly, it almost seems like it was meant for 2 fingers, but I like using 1. Before we get to the firing test and chrono readings, I'm going to show you some reloads. I kid you not, I am not over exaggerating when I do this. Onto the firing test. I will be firing with the included green Adventure Force wafflehead darts. And now on to the chrono readings. The average totaled to about 90.94 feet per second. That's really good for a stock blaster that you can get for $20. Overall, I think the Spectrum is a really, really great semi-automatic primary or even secondary, because there is multiple sling mounts on the stock and up here. I couldn't see myself ever using this as necessarily a sidearm, but again, a really good primary or secondary. That's all for today. Go comment and check out my channel if you like my content. Maybe subscribe. It'd really help out the channel. I like comments. You probably like comments too. See ya.